Hello, my friends. It's time to unleash the Germans once again. As the war grinds on, advanced tanks for India, level 3. And anti-aircraft defense, level 1. Maybe they can do something with that now. Oh, what a snapback that was. Oh, they pulled them back. You know, these guys are like farming partisans. Hey, that's pretty good. Okay. Nice. Okay. The air problem for Russia. She's not managed to buy anti-air defense upgrades. Thank you. again with these wretched V3 rockets, V2 rockets. Nice. Whoa. Severe damage for them there. Nice. I can't let them get my HQ. We gotta pull right back. Coming for you soon. Okay. Look at all this trash. Okay, alright, let's worry about Russia first. This unit is behind my lines, but this unit won't be commanded, but I can overstrengthen this. Okay. Operated. No. Have any new units this turn? Nope. It's actually a river here. Let's hope it holds while I evacuate that front. Okay. Defense in depth, as it were. Advanced tanks level 3 is here. How much that's going to help, I have no clue. I'm going to have to just retreat everything and put a defense along this road. Starting at Orsk and building along this road. And then maybe here too. And then up. I don't know, but we can't hold. That's the bottom line. So, Russia will just have to pull back. Will Russia hold until Japan gets nuked? Is another question entirely. Right. Oh, one country. Level 4 tanks on the way. Some air defense upgrades. I'll have to truffle shuffle that infantry out because it can't go anywhere by itself, and then drive the tank away too. Okay. Nothing to do here on the Japanese front. On the Chinese front, I should say. They did not push forward and break that defense. Okay. One, two, three. Yep, just needs three sides. Just in case. Save my shells for potentially another breakthrough. Okay, so they got a unit from me, but I got a unit from them, so that's tit for tat. Okay, let's deal with this. I don't know, he must have gone under these in here. There he is. Oh! To port with you. Well, I'm glad I brought so much fleet with me to go after this sub because of the amount of Italian fleet around. Why would you do that? Why wouldn't you just go around? Okay, well at least it's dead. Alright, battleship. Find me some Italian stuff. Good hit. There it is. It's in port where I'm basically going to struggle to touch it. Nice. Okay, they got extra bonus damage on me there. Oh, that was unusual. I got a crit. That doesn't happen every day. Damn. Okay. Well, that's two subs sunk. Guess we'll have to see what damage the Italians are able to do on their turn, if any. Two subs and a destroyer are gone, and I think that's all I saw. I think this might be the last ship. Okay. It's time for more long-range amphibious transport cheese. apparently that's the only way you can get any damage done in this game. Oh, you suck. All these guys are doing is feeding experience points to the enemy. Seriously. That's all they do. Is depressing to think about. I think that this fighter is vulnerable. To a bit of, I think that this fighter is vulnerable to a bit of long-range amphibious transport cheese. And that I can just go here and attack it directly because it's on the coastline. Okay, the spot seems to be undefended. God, he highballed again. Basically, we land the ones that whose strikes have been used, and we just refresh the strikes. Give me the experience points, boys! Oh, low-balled. Oh, but then I high-balled. Nice. Still got a couple of shells here. Do I go after it, or do I just leave it there? Okay, that morale is trashed. I think I just leave him there. Okay. You know, the standard one doesn't reach very far. Okay. I'm gonna hit Rangoon from behind. If we could kill any unit here, and any unit here, that would be ideal. These three would then be encircled. These settlements have no strategic value. So it would seem. Level 4 bombing. As I secure this front area. I have a level 4 anti-aircraft defense. But even the dedicated anti-air can only go to 3. So what are the extra ranks for? There doesn't seem to be anything that uses more than 2 points, more than 3 points of anti-air. Three seems to be the limit. So this research is pointless. Just another bizarre thing I found in this game. Right, let's buy that last mechanized. Maybe the last set of tacticals. No more fighters. Okay. Cavalry Corps? It's a US blimp. It's got great spotting if you give it lots of long-range aircraft upgrades. Ah, Russia's gonna break, I think. Oh man, this game. My next goal will be to, because I've got anti-aircraft guns, right? So in fact, let's stick this one in a transport. Once I've secured this area, I think what I'll do is I'll load up, once I've secured this and this, which is going to be many more turns, but I think what I'll do is I'll get all my guys in transports and then hit this. Now I can get a foothold in Japan. I'm sure that will annoy them. I'll see what else I can do to break their will to resist. We want to kill him here rather than attack Bangkok directly. I need to recover Rangoon because it's going to give extra money to China as well. So, I wouldn't say the situation is urgent, but yeah, 44. Man, if we could even drop behind the Chinese here, that would be huge. Such units would be in big trouble fast, though. Okay, I guess that's it for now. I hope you guys enjoyed it, and I'll see you guys next time.